Today we're going to be talking about social media and why I think it's so important. And I think you're going to find that the reasons and the main reason why I think it's so important is going to be, I think, a little different than most people. And while I'm doing that, I thought I would just go ahead and keep working on this. This is an old drawing I found in my flat file. And I've completely changed it, but there was something about it that I always liked, even though it's not a great composition and it's not a great drawing, but I always really enjoyed it. Don't know why. And I think it's this arm. I just love this forearm here, you know, and just one little arm has made me love the whole thing. It's crazy. Sometimes I get hooked on little elements, a single element of a drawing and like that. And I think it's because in every drawing, I find something that I like and that I learn from, and I try to catalog that in my head and try to use that in future drawings. But in this particular one, I thought I would just go ahead and start throwing charcoal over it. I mean, I think it even has a bad drawing on the back. Ouch! That's how old this piece of paper is. But anyhow, so I've thrown powdered charcoal over the whole thing, and I even dropped some acetone on it, which I'm going to do a video on. But anyhow, I thought I would just I'd work on this a little bit while I talked about Instagram specifically, Facebook as well, but Instagram specifically, because I feel that Instagram is one of the best platforms for discovery. Is that you can get on Instagram and you got these great search features that'll allow you to find some absolutely amazing work. You can follow people. And not only that, you can learn so much by just viewing other people's work and what they're doing, how they're doing it. You can talk with them. It's a great platform for sharing artwork, which rolls me around to one of the main reasons I use Instagram is, and I can't remember if I read this or where I got it from. I wish I could, but it's not an original idea from me. But somebody once said that art had a circular, let me see if I can find a piece of paper. Had a circular life. So let's give it a little circle here. And it's the idea. And then you go through this whole thing about, conception, visualization. You're going to get where you start accumulating photography, reference materials, things like that if you need it. You got execution. I'm not going to write all these down, but you can see that this arrow is just kind of moving around. And then, you start building it, refining it until the piece is finally done. And by the time it gets back all the way to the beginning, it's about viewing. It's about people viewing your idea. That's the end. The end of a piece of work is for your voice to be seen and heard by as many people as you want, and as many people as you can get. But that's the end of a piece. It's not the accumulation of monetary. Oh, I'm done. Monetize it. It's not how art is. Art in history has been a communication of the time period, how the government, the church, what they're going through, how they're doing it. It's really a visual catalog of history in a very interesting way. And that's art. And so when I create work, I, on the average, create work for myself. And in the end, when I consider a piece done is when I do, a photograph of it and I put it out to the world. And I use Instagram for that. You can use Facebook. You can use DeviantArt, any other platform that there is out there. But that's when that piece is finished. And sure, people are going to say, you can come back. And I do it all the time. I go back and I rework pieces, hence why I'm doing this one here. So this one actually has two life cycles. The first one, and now this second one, he's going to go through this other life cycle events, if you will. But that's why I use Instagram. And I think you shouldn't be so concerned about how big of an audience you have or monetizing your work constantly. Do the work for yourself. The monetization will come later, but the work has to happen, and it has to happen over and over and over again, piece after piece. And you got to take these pieces to a final. You can't just do a small little sketch and go, okay, good, next one, small little sketch, okay, good, that one, small little sketch, over and over again. You got to be doing final finished pieces because you learn so much throughout the whole process. Even on this one, I learn every single piece. I think about creases. I think about light. I think about shape. I think about muscles. I think about anatomy. And I go in and I'll do my research and I'll look up anatomy and I'll look up muscles and stomachs and hands and all that kind of stuff. Skulls, I'll pull out my skull. And so you learn, but you only learn if you move through the whole process. Go through the whole circle. Get it. Do it all. Do it all. And over and over and as many times as you possibly can, because you will get better and better and better and better. And the better you get, the faster your Instagram account will grow. People will enjoy the work. And also, it'll help you find your voice. And I think that's another really important part of this whole thing, is finding your voice. And by doing artwork over and over again and putting it out to the world, letting people see it, letting people view it, and then letting it go, is going to do more for you as an artist than to do a piece and then try to figure out how you can monetize it. Do a piece, how can you monetize it? Every single piece then becomes a exercise in monetization. In other words, every piece is actually tainted by the idea that you want to monetize it and get it out there. And I'm saying, get rid of that idea of monetizing it and just let the pieces live. Let them go through their natural process all the way to the end. Enjoy the end, post the end, and then later decide if it's something that you want to make prints of, if you want to sell the piece, or if you just want to keep the piece. Or if the piece lives in a flat file, like I have a ton of pieces living in a flat file. And I'm okay with that. I'm absolutely okay with that. Not every piece is a sellable piece. Not every piece has an audience. Or maybe it's going to be a while before the right person comes along that's going to appreciate the piece the way I do. So anyhow, Instagram, share your pieces. Do as many as you can. Go the full cycle from idea to creation all the way to the end to where you're sharing it. And then consider that the end. Let it go and move on to the next piece. You can be every week, you can have a day or an afternoon that you can think about which pieces you might want to monetize and which ones you don't. But leave that for another day. Take that out of your process and out of your thinking and out of your thought pattern completely. So hope this helps. Probably not, just me rambling on, but I'm kind of passionate about that particular idea. So anyhow, take care. Thanks for following. And let me know if you have any ideas on the topic below. So take care.